Cardinals. Davis fakes one way and looks the other. Look at the arm strength on this kid. And he's able to complete the pass to his big-time receiver, Lewis Johnson. Their side of the 50-yard line. Davis, feeling some pressure, is able to get it out. And once again, it's Lewis Johnson who comes back to hit. First and 10 for Ball State. At the 27, Davis looking, has a man wide open in the middle. To the ground game, McCoy Lewis gets it. He spurts out of the middle, touchdown Ball State. All right, thank you, Steve. On 3rd and 3, Hiller rolling out, has a man, and it looks like it's going to be picked off. Sean Baker once again. Cardinals now at the 40-yard line, driving yet again up by 7. The fake to Lewis. Davis steps up in the pocket, makes a throw on a rope. Man wide open, cut back, touchdown, Cardinals. Two quarterbacks in the game now. Hiller under center. Gets the pitch out to Burry, the backup quarterback. And the trick play is good for 6. Broncos on the board. 14-7. Hiller back to pass, looking for the fade route. Has a man wide open. Given up in 12 games this season. Doing a great job of protecting Nate Davis. Now on 3rd and 18, Davis fires across the middle. And it's his go-to freshman, Briggs Orsbon, who...
I just think it's too much to ask.
Davis on 3rd and 7, flushed out of the pocket. He'll run for it. He's got some room. He's only 3 of 7 at 40 or more this season, so we'll see if he can convert here.
We're deep into the college football season. Everybody's saying, well, who's going to be the national football champion in college football? And as you know, there's no playoff system. They've got the bowl series, championship series, championship playoff series. And it's always very unsatisfying. But now, ladies and gentlemen, with only a couple weeks in the regular season to go, a clear-cut national champion is emerging. I'm, of course, talking about your Fighting Ball State Cardinals.
Davis back, gets the pressure, lots of beautiful pass up the middle. Darius Hill, and he's finally corralled at the 5-yard line by repeat of Georgia Hawaii. They're at 2nd and goal right now and threatening yet again. Up 3, Davis, escapability, goes into play one more time. Sees the goal line and the magnetism of the end zone. Gets Nate Davis in for 6 for the Cardinals.
And I love the bowl system. It rewards a lot of programs.
On 1st and 10, McQuay Lewis cuts it back, gets a big block from his cornerback, and the last man there to save the day is Lewis Dell.
It's a quandary.
3rd down and 10 for the Cardinals. Davis scrambles out of the pocket, flush to the right, and he finds his man, the freshman, Briggs Orsbon. 1st and 10 for the Cardinals, driving yet again. Low snap, Davis handles it, looks down the middle, has a man wide open. Darius Hill on the reception.
You can't find him, you can't see him. And when Lewis hits the hole, he's on you before you know it.
Lewis up the middle, touchdown Cardinals. Hill will try it again, and this one's picked clean. Trey Lewis dials up a pick 6. Up the middle goes Brandon West, and it's a touchdown for the Broncos. 3rd and 2 for the Cardinals, and I'll give you my point for this play. Davis back, passing, connects, and once again it's Darius Hill coming up big as we go back.
McQuay Lewis picked up a lot of that slack.
2nd and 7. Davis flush from the pocket. Down the sideline he goes, and he gets a stiff bit of resistance from Mark. 3rd and goal for the Cardinals. Lewis stays on his feet. Touchdown, Ball State.
It's the Ball State Fighting Cardinals. Let me remind you, you're saying, Cardinals, ladies and gentlemen, for you ornithologists, any ornithologists in the audience? Are the fiercest robin-sized bird in the world. Look out. They will roost on your lower lip and peck your nose off.
Ah.
Well, the biggest party in Muncie history since 1965 is just about ready to get underway with a minute 14. The fans have left the stands. They are down courtside, and they are ready to storm the field as Tanner Justice comes in. He'll take a knee, maybe one more, and that will do it.
And the PA announcer here said, please do not come onto the field after the game.
Yeah, right. Good luck with that one.
Yeah. They came bolting out of the stands during that break, and they are stacked and packed on the sidelines, ready to rush the field, and rightly so, because the Ball State Cardinals go to 8-0, 12-0, and they will face Buffalo in the MAC championship game December 5th at Ford Field in Detroit.
I'll tell you what, I would love your idea of Boise State and Ball State meeting somewhere, anywhere. To get those two teams on the field, that would be an exciting matchup. Last 30 seconds tick away for a perfect season for Brady Hoke and his team. And Brady Hoke, unfortunately, is going to be a little colder tonight. Ball State, 454 yards, no turnovers, and just one penalty.
Those are all hallmarks of an outstanding football team. Give all the credit in the world to Brady Hoke and his Cardinals coming through with a dream season, finishing the regular season 12-0, 8-0 in the Mid-American Conference on their way to the MAC championship game.
From Muncie, Indiana, to the Ed Sullivan Theater in New York City, let it be known the Ball State Cardinals are perfect in 2008. That's probably a tradition he'd like to do without.
Ah, they're nothing better than one of those.
Well, our congratulations to Brady Hoke, his staff, the school, the entire community. Fantastic. Our final score, 45-22. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.